Today, we head back to the Peach State, Georgia, for another event at Road Atlanta.
Thank you.
Now we return to the Ardennes Forest in Belgium and the Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps.
Thank you.
we head back to beautiful Barcelona to challenge the Circuit de Catalunya once again.
Thank you.
We are heading back to the streets of Le Mans, France, for today's event at the iconic Circuit de la Sarthe.
Thank you. At the turn of the century, Le Mans wasn't just a race you visited to watch Audi repeatedly walk off with the big trophy. It was a race you visited to watch harder, nastier GT versions of fast road cars kicking great lumps out of each other's bodywork. Here then we have some of the finest production cars born of the racetrack. Cars like the Dodge Viper GTS ACR, a car so violent it makes the normal 8-litre V10 powered Viper look timid. Cars like the 360 Challenge Stradale, which packed Ferrari's GT racing know-how into a car you could drive to the shops, as long as you didn't mind arriving at the shops with blood gushing from your ears. Many of these cars should never have been allowed on the public road. They were designed to race, and be warned, they do not suffer fools gladly. Tread carefully and pack fresh undergarments.
This is your 2005 TVR Sagaris. We now head back to scenic Southern California for an event at the Temporary Street Circuit in Long Beach.
Thank you.
Our next event takes place high in the Bernese Alps in Switzerland. returned to England for another event at the famous Silverstone Circuit.
We'll be right back.
we head back for another event in historic Prague, a city that was founded over 1,000 years ago. We now return to the forests of Nürburgring, Germany for our next event at the Nürburgring.
Thank you.
travel back to Wisconsin for another event at historic Road America, where the layout has remained unaltered for more than 50 years.
We'll be right back.
We return to scenic Barcelona and the Circuit de Catalunya, home of the Spanish Grand Prix. We return to the hot asphalt of Georgia for an event at Road Atlanta.
We'll be right back.
We head once again to Belgium for another event at the Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps, home of the Belgian Grand Prix.
Thank you.
We return to the home of the Bathurst 1000, the Mount Panorama Circuit in Australia.
Thank you. men might not have been men in the 1980s, but the cars we drove, Testarossa, Countach, M1, even the names have enough testosterone to make you forgive the decade that taste forgot. In Europe, king of the hill was the 180-mile-an-hour Ferrari, the 512 TR, the second-generation Testarossa, with its vast air intakes chilling a 5-litre flat 12 engine that seemed to occupy acres of the back of the car, and also the road. Being fastest was, of course, the obsession in the me 1980s, and Lamborghini wasn't lying down. The LP5000 QV was the final and fastest version of Countach, which started life back in 1974. The BMW M1 and Ferrari GTO, meanwhile, were the fruits of racing projects, though neither really ever got to compete. Sporting regulations were as flighty as fashion in the 1980s.
This is your 1981 BMW M1. We now head back to the Nürburgring, a demanding track used by the world's top automakers as a test of a car's performance. head back to Silverstone Circuit, known as the home of British motor racing.
Some say he's the Stig, but he's not. He's the Stig's digital cousin. The next event takes us back to Florida and the historic Sebring International Raceway.
Thank you. Thank you.